My name is Tom Bruno. I'm a research chemist at NIST, and I lead a research group that works on separations research. Well, in the area of fuel properties, in the last 2 years, we've developed what's called the advanced distillation curve approach. The advanced distillation curve is a method of measuring the volatility of complex fluids such as fuels. These fluids are not really amenable to a page in a chemical handbook because there are thousands and thousands of components. So what you do is you put it into a flask like this and you boil it and you measure the temperature at which each fraction comes over. Now that's a classical measurement that's been measured for many years. What we've introduced are ways to make the measurement much less uncertain and much more information rich. We use new sampling devices such as the one shown here to analyze each cut, and I mean tiny fractional cuts, on the fly. As a matter of fact, we have a collaboration with the University of Illinois in which Professor Zhang's group is actually making a crude oil substitute out of pig manure. Now here you have a material that's a complete nuisance. It has no value whatsoever, but his research group has been able to turn it into a fluid, and I have a little bit of it here, that's very similar to a crude oil. Well, we've applied our advanced distillation curve approach to that fluid, and we can use it to determine what areas that the pig manure fuel can be used in. Biofuels are important because, as we all know, using petroleum-based fuels is like living off of your granddad's inheritance. I mean, it's fun for a while, but when the money starts to run out, it's not so much fun anymore. Using biofuels provides a renewable source that can be used in perpetuity. So, while we don't make biofuels, we're providing industry with the underlying data that's needed for them to design engines and processes based on biofuels.